Hello, welcome to Research 601, Module 1. What I want to do is go through the steps that you'll be doing in your session-long project. If you've already read the session-long project, then you'll know that you're entering the point in the research where you've already done your proposal, you've already collected your data, and now you have your raw data set. And so what we want to do now is prepare that raw data set for analysis. As you go through, before you're ready to start testing your hypothesis, there's a number of steps that need to be done. The first step is handling the data set and preparing it for analysis. And there's really two main things we're looking at there. The first one is deleting invalid cases. The second one is replacing any missing values we have. Those are the two things we're going to go through in this module and let you play with it a little bit. Now you have a raw data set that we provided you, this one you've collected. So the first thing you want to do is go through and make sure that each case is valid. Now a case is your response from one participant, okay? When you go through your case, what you're looking for is variables that aren't properly measured. Let's take case 9. You see a missing value here. They've missed one item on the organizational commitment scale. Missing one item out of 10, that's not a big deal. Usually, I want at least 4 items, and I want a majority of the items to be reported. So if they miss 1 or 2 or even 3, if it's a larger scale, I can replace those items with the statistical mean without hurting the use of the spreadsheet. It'll still be good for analysis. But if I'm missing more than that, then the case is really not usable. So looking at case 9, I look here on the task performance scale, and I see they didn't answer anything. Same thing with the organizational citizenship behavior scale. So this case, this participant's response is of no use to me. So what am I gonna do? I'm gonna right click, delete, and make it go away. All right, so that one's out of the way. Now this next case, I see it is also missing a lot of data. So I'm gonna just right click, delete. Case 11, going to delete it. Here's one that's also partially incomplete. That's case 22 here. I'm going to delete that one. And what you want to do is just work through the scale and delete all the cases that are incomplete, that are invalid, that are missing more than just a few items for each scale. Right now we have 460-something cases in this scale. By the time you finish deleting these invalid cases, that'll be much smaller. But that's what you have to do first, is delete all those invalid cases because they're of no use to you. The next thing you want to do then, once you've done that, you want to save this file with a new name. You don't want to overwrite your raw data set. My recommendation is take your raw data set and save it right off the bat and make a copy of it for this and just call it raw data set 2, that'll be fine, or working raw data set. Once you've deleted invalid cases, give it a new name, like raw data or data set with invalid cases removed. Okay, and then that's the one we're gonna upload to SPSS. Okay, so here we are in SPSS in the data editor, and that's the same case. Once we've done it all, you'll see here we've got, after we deleted all the missing cases, we got 263 cases remaining. All right. Out of that 263, we have missing values every once in a while. There's a few missing values. Here's one here. We need to replace those. There's a couple of ways to replace them. The easiest way is just to go transform, replace missing values. Okay. Let's just select all of our measured items, all 31 of them, put them over here, all right, and say okay. Now, a couple of things I want to point out here. What this replace missing values on your output editor does here is it tells you for each variable, like the first question, OC1, had no missing values, okay, so don't worry about that. Case 2 had no missing values. Case 3 had one missing value and it was replaced. Now, if we go down, we see OC7 had 12. 26 had 18, 27 had 19, 29 had 38 values replaced. Okay, that's a lot of values. How much is too much? Well, there's several rules of thumb, depending on which author's criteria you accept. I usually use Cresswell, who says 15%. 15% is the limit. So we had 263 cases. That's going to be roughly 40. 40 would be 15% right in that ballpark. So as long as there's less than 40, we're okay. And all of these are less than 40. Now this here, the last thing you will do in the SOP is you will prepare a written report. When you're doing your dissertation, you're going to need to be copying your output, formatting, and then put it into your document. The way you do that is click on it, right-click copy, okay, and then go to an Excel file. We'll just use this one, and right-click paste. Okay, so here it is in Excel. Now you can manipulate it. You can change all the writing to the same color. You can do whatever you need to do to prepare this, and then you can copy it out of here and paste it into your document. Okay, back to our data set here. Now, once you did that, what happened to all those new variables? So what it did is it saved all these as new variables, all right? And where it saved it at was after the original one. So if we go out here, we'll see now we start over with OC1 through OC1, all right? You can work with it like that, but it's easier to just block it all. So we're going to go out to 31. We're going to go down to 263. Okay. We're just going to take the whole new set, copy it, come back to OC1, and let's just paste it over the old set. All right, and now let's go back to our new set, starting with OC1. Let's just block all of those. And delete them. Okay, so now we have our new data set. We've cleaned it by removing the invalid cases. And then we've replaced our missing values, and now it's ready for the next step in analysis, which we'll do next module. Thank you. Have fun with this.